Good morning, CHS, and welcome to the very first broadcast of The Buzz. I'm Reagan Mead, one of your anchors.
And I'm the other, Kim Molnix. Our goal as The Buzz News is to bring you the stories of Cleburne High School.
In recent weeks, our CHS administration participated in the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge in order to promote awareness for the disease. The ALS Association is the only national nonprofit health organization dedicated solely to the fight against the disease.
It attacks nerve cells and the pathways in the brain and spinal cord. People diagnosed with it have a life expectancy estimated from 2 to 5 years.
We hope this makes you more aware of how serious this affects those diagnosed. We urge you to donate in order to put an end to this disease.
If you are interested in joining CHS Stuco, you can pick up an application in the main office. Dues are $25 and due to Mr. Cotton in room CC9A before September 26th.
We would also like to give a huge thanks to Stuco for putting on the recent blood drive. Without this life-saving gift, many would suffer. For those who participated, pat yourself on the back.
Let's take a look at one of the blood draws and find out why donors are so happy to give.
Hi, I'm Reagan Mead, and I'm here with Israel again, and this is The Buzz. He is currently donating blood right now. How does it feel donating blood?
It feels good. It's kind of painful, though.
It's scary.
Definitely. How does it feel to donate blood?
Scary at first, and then you think it's a good cause, so you do it.
Hi, I'm Reagan, and I'm here with Mateo Barcenas. What made you decide to donate blood today?
I don't know. You know, it's for a good cause, you know. I'm always up for doing things for good causes.
Why did you decide to donate blood today?
I don't know. It just felt like the right thing to do.
Why did you decide to donate blood today?
Because it's for a good cause.
If you could donate again, would you, and why?
Yeah, most definitely. It just seems like it would be the right thing to do, and a chance to do it again would be better.
Hi, I'm Reagan, and I'm here with Ms. Sherry. How do you feel about so many students donating blood today?
I think it's a very good thing because it gets them started, and hopefully they'll be future donors and continue on donating.
How long have you been working for Red Cross?
For 18 years.
Have you donated blood yourself, and why?
Yes, I have. I received blood myself. I received 3 units, and I was glad for everyone that gave. And I'm glad that everybody's here giving. That's why I'm giving, too.
All right. Thank you so much, Michelle. This is Reagan Mead signing off for The Buzz. Goodbye.
A special shout-out goes to Mr. Cotton and his students for building our studio desk. Thank you. Now, for Yellow Jacket Sports Week.
With Hannah and Tim.
Hey, what's up? I'm Tim.
And I'm Hannah. Welcome to our first episode.
So to get started here in Yellow Jacket Sports Week, the football team opened its season at home to Lake Ridge and hit the road to Boswell in Week 2. Both games were losses, but the Jackets are working hard towards a win. The last game against Azle was proof that our players are moving in the right direction, especially our defensive line. They did a great job of holding off the Hornets. Players of the week against Boswell were quarterback Brian Baca, defensive end Jonathan Rice, and outside linebacker Johnny Juarez. Next week is a bye week. District play for football starts September 26th against Crowley at Crowley at 7:30 p.m. Come out and support the team.
Moving on to volleyball, the Lady Jackets are starting the season with a new coach, Holly Fitch. After tough fights against Azle and Weatherford, the Lady Jackets come up with losses. The Lady Jackets played hard against Chisholm Trail on September 9th during a 4-set game, but were unable to win. According to Coach Fish, it's going to take a lot of work on helping them feel more comfortable when going up to hit. The most valuable players for all of these games were Monty Sorrells, Kelsey Chavez, and Kristen Reed.
Moving on across country, the team has an enormous amount of optimism for this season. In the words of their coach King, "The runners are looking strong, we're aiming high this year, train harder, stay home." For boys varsity, Reagan Mead, Luis Suaste, Clayton Reynolds, Anthony Estrada, Pedro Munoz, Ann Webb, and Omar Flores have purpose to keep their district title. The Lady Jackets varsity team has also had an optimistic season thus far. According to Coach Gentry, the varsity girls Taya Berry, Vanessa Gonzalez, Marion Rico, and Hannah Carr are focused on competing with their teammates and trying to better themselves when it comes time for district. Compete, compete, compete. That's always the answer.
The tennis team matched up against Burleson High, Everman, and Granbury. 2 out of 3 games were wins. According to junior Kylie Connor, the team's strongest point is their veteran players. The Jackets will hit the road to Everman for their next match.
Next up, highlights of the Lady Jackets game against Azle and Chisholm Trail.
Highlights for football will be the Boswell game. Azle will be shown next Friday.
Your picture perfect blue, sunbathing on
your bones illuminate. First kiss just like a drug, under your influence. It took me over, you're the magic in my veins. This must be love.
Never know if you'll get stung.
If we're asking questions,
be ready to answer.
How would you define a hater?
Haters are my motivator.
How would y'all define a hater?
I don't know, someone that hates me.
How do you define a hater?
Somebody who hates.
A hater is somebody who hates on somebody who's awesome.
What's a hater?
How would you define a hater?
All them over there.
All right, all them. Look at them. All them over there.
I love you, haters. Someone that doesn't like anybody or someone that doesn't like anything.
Haters are like people who hate and stuff.
How would you define a hater, Bo?
A terrible person.
What about you, Armando? If you could give any advice to a hater to quit hating, what would it be?
Be nice. Find something good in yourself and you'll learn to like others.
What advice would you give to haters to quit hating?
What kind of advice would you have for a hater so they quit being haters?
Chill out. Take a jail pill, too.
Just quit hating.
Don't do that.
What kind of advice do you have for them haters?
Be nice to people.
Find what makes them happy.
You haters need happy. That's what she said. Buzzing around out.
For The Buzz, I'm Reagan Mead.
And I'm Kimberly Melnitz. We hope this first episode has entertained you and keeps you wanting more Buzz News. Goodbye.
Bye. 'Cause the players gonna play, and the haters gonna hate, baby. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake it off.